So good afternoon, everyone. Before we lead into the very important ceremony that we're here to celebrate today, some introductions. My name's Jane, and it's my pleasure to be conducting the ceremony. My colleague Ian is all ready to register your marriage today. So a very warm welcome to you all to this historic venue here at Pembroke Castle, where we've gathered to celebrate this very special occasion for Stuart and for Tunley. In the time they've been together, their love and understanding of each other has grown, and now they've decided to live their lives together as husband and wife. So having made this important and very personal decision, they've chosen today to publicly celebrate their love for each other by exchanging the vows that will unite them in marriage, and have invited all of you, their family and friends, to be with them to witness this important step. So for Ian and I, it is our duty to be here today, but it's also a great honour for us to share in this part of your day. And I'm sure all your guests here would like to join with the both of us in wishing you every good fortune for a long and happy life together. For Stuart and Tony, getting married today is a proud confirmation of the love, friendship, and respect they have for each other. Marriage requires devotion, the ability to listen, the wisdom to know when we are wrong, but most importantly, the strength to put things right. Today, Stuart and Tony, you will exchange vows which will unite you as husband and wife. The words are a formal and public of your love and a promise of a lifelong commitment to each other. Now, in celebration of their marriage, Stuart and Tony have chosen two readings, and the first is to be read by Jade. So, could I ask Jade to come up, please?
A lovely love story by Edward Monckton. The fierce dinosaur was trapped inside his cage of ice. Although it was cold, he was happy in there. It was, after all, his cage. Then along came the lovely other dinosaur. The lovely other dinosaur melted the dinosaur's cage with kind words and loving thoughts. I like this dinosaur, thought the lovely other dinosaur. Although he is fierce, he is also tender and he is funny. He is also quite clever, although I will not tell him this for now. I like this lovely other dinosaur, thought the dinosaur. She is beautiful and she is different and she smells so nice. She is also a free spirit, which is a quality I much admire in a dinosaur. But he can be so distant and so peculiar at times, thought the lovely. But her mind skips from here to there so quickly, thought the dinosaur. She is also uncommonly keen on shopping. Are all lovely other dinosaurs so uncommonly keen on shopping? I will forgive his peculiarity and his concern for things, thought the lovely other dinosaur, for they are part of what make him a richly captured individual. I will forgive her skipping mind and her fondness for shopping, thought the dinosaur, for she fills our life with beautiful thought and wonderful surprises. Besides, I am not keen on shopping either. Now the dinosaur and lovely other dinosaur are old. Look at them. Together they stand on the hill telling each other stories and feeling the warmth of the sun on their backs. And that, my friends, is how it is with love. Let us all be dinosaurs and lovely other dinosaurs together, for the sun is warm and the world is a beautiful place.
Has been duly sanctioned according to law for the celebration of marriages. You are here to witness the joining in matrimony of Stuart Clive Curlew and Tony Maria Mackay. I ask therefore if any person knows of any just cause or impediment why they may not be lawfully married to each other, you should declare it now. That's a good sign. So Stuart and Tony, you've chosen today to make a public commitment to each other. When two people pledge to love and care for each other in marriage, they create a unique spirit that binds them closer than any spoken or written word can do. Marriage is a promise made in the hearts of two people and takes a lifetime to fulfil. So before you are joined in matrimony, I have to remind you of the solemn and binding character of the vows you're about to make. Marriage in this country is the union of two people, voluntarily entered into for life, to the exclusion of all others. It's a solemn union to provide the love, friendship, help and comfort that each ought to have for the other. It should not be entered into lightly, nor lightly put aside. So now I'm going to ask you each in turn to declare that you know of no legal reason why you may not be married to each other. So please reply I am now to the following questions. I'm Stuart Curley. Are you Stuart Clive Curley, free lawfully to marry Tony Maria Mackay?
I am.
Are you Tony Maria Mackay, free lawfully to marry Stuart Clive Curley?
I am.
So you've heard Stuart and Tony declare they're free to marry. So we now come to the solemn moment where they formally contract their marriage before all of you, their witnesses. So if I could ask everyone to stand now at this point, please. If you could take your pass your hand. So if you would like to turn now and face each other, please. Words you're about to say, repeat after me, but you're speaking into each other. So Stuart and Tony, the words you're about to say to each other will stand as your promises for your life together. So look at each other and remember this moment in time and the love you feel for each other today. So Stuart. I, Stuart Clive Curlew.
I, Stuart Clive Curlew.
Take you, Tony Maria Mackay.
Sorry.
Take you, Tony Maria Mackay.
Take you, Tony Maria Mackay.
Okay, to be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
And Tony? I, Tony Maria Mackay.
I, Tony Maria Mackay.
Take you, Stuart Clive Curlew.
Take you, Stuart Clive Curlew.
To be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
And now your further promises. So, Stuart, I make these promises to you today.
I make these promises to you today.
To laugh with you in joy.
To laugh with you in joy.
To care for you in times of sorrow.
Care for you in times of sorrow.
To trust you where there is doubt.
To trust you where there is doubt.
To love, honour and protect you.
Love, honour and protect you.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
Tony, I make these promises to you today.
I make these promises to you today.
To laugh with you in joy.
To laugh with you in joy.
To care for you in times of sorrow.
To care for you in times of sorrow.
To trust you where there is doubt.
To trust you where there is doubt.
To love, honour and cherish you.
To love, honour and cherish you.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
So if you'd all like to be seated now, please. Hand from the bell. Now, throughout human history, when you make a pledge, it's been traditional to have a token to remind you of that pledge. And for that purpose today, you've chosen to exchange rings. So, Brian, just want to hold them. The wedding ring is an unbroken circle. It has no beginning and it has no end. It symbolises an ending and everlasting love, and is an outward sign of the lifelong promises you've now made to each other. So Stuart, if you'd like to take Tony's ring, please, and place it on the tip of her finger. So repeat after me, but speak to Tony. I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a symbol of our marriage.
As a symbol of our marriage.
And of the commitment,
and of the commitment
we have made to each other,
now and forever. now and forever.
Thank you.
Place it on the tip. I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a symbol of our marriage.
As a symbol of our marriage.
And of the commitment.
And of the commitment.
We have made to each other.
We have made to each other.
Now and forever.
Now and forever.
Well done. So we're now going to hear the second reading, and if I could ask Gina to come up, please, for that.
Always has the lid on, and he always shuts the door. He's very clean and tidy, though he may sometimes delude. Leave your things out at your peril. In a second, they'll be moved. She romances and dines him, home-cooked dinners and the like. She even knows his favourite food and spoils him day and night. She's thoughtful when he looks at her, a smile upon his face. Will he look that good in 50 years when his dentures aren't in place? He says he loves her figure and her mental prowess too, but when gravity takes over, will she charm him with her IQ? She says she loves his kindness and his patience is a must, and of course she thinks he's handsome, which in her eyes is a plus. They're both not wholly perfect, but who are we to judge? It can be pig-headed, where she won't even budge. All that said and done, they love the time they spend together, and I hope, I'm sure you do, that this fine day will last forever. He'll be more than just a husband, he'll also be her friend, and she'll be more than just his wife, she'll be a soulmate till the end. This poem is for bride and groom, a married couple now. It's a token of the love they share and the thought behind each vow.
Thank you, Gina. Stuart and Tony, may you have happiness and may you find it making one another happy. May you have love and may you find it loving one another. The best thing about love, it's an experience we can all share. And to find the right person to share your love with is surely one of life's greatest achievements. So on behalf of Ian and myself, I'd like to extend our very best wishes to you both and wish you every happiness in your future life together. But now it only remains for me to say, Stuart Clive Curlew and Tony Maria McAvey. You have both made the declarations prescribed by law and have made a solemn and binding contract with each other in the presence of your witnesses, family and friends gathered here today. So now it's my pleasure and my privilege to pronounce your husband and wife together. So congratulations to you both. Stuart, I'm sure you would love to kiss your beautiful bride. Bear with us now, and we're
I'm not sure.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, would you please be upstanding for the bride and groom?
Thank you all for coming today to celebrate Tony and what's his name? Stuart. Stuart's wedding today. I know you've come from all parts of the compass today and made much effort to get here. And it's very nice to see you all. There's lots of old friends and family, not old, but family, and lots of new friends and new family here today. And it's lovely to see you all. I'd like to say I'd sat down and written something down, but that's really not the case. Because you can't write anything down about Tony and Stuart, because they're completely off the wall. Well, I've got a lot more to say, but in the words of Gina, from one dinosaur, having been married for 43 years, from one dinosaur to another, if you'd like to take a little advice, there's two words to end every conversation, and that is, yes, dear.
You've already known.
I hand you over to the best man. Thank you.
Right, my turn. Well, when Stuart asked me to do this, I thought, well, which way do I go about this? Because being the, father and best man as well, it's a sort of a bit like being a double agent, really, because it's normally the best man's job to bring out the, recall the most embarrassing moments of the groom's and expose all his darkest secrets, really. Whereas, as a parent, on the other hand, it was my job to cover his tracks. You know, and I said, all I can say is I must have done a good job, because Tony did agree to marry him. Didn't he? I'd like to also reciprocate some of the things that Steve said. I'd like to thank, first of all, the bridesmaids. I think they've all, today, they've all done a marvellous job and they all look fantastic. Stephanie, yeah, and Brooke, and Abby, yeah, very well. And they're of course only eclipsed by Tony herself. I think that looks absolutely stunning there. I've got a bit of a thank you to do now for Jason. Where he sat over there, Jason. Look. Jason did a wonderful job on Stuart's stag. For those who didn't know, we went to the dogs at Pool, and I think my dog's still running, actually. Well, we were all like cushioned by the fact that we could all have a drink when we were losing money. Poor Jason had to stay sober. And I'd like to make up for now, and we've got to make sure you're not going to be sober tonight. We've got a few cans for you to make up. Let's get to some serious stuff. We'll get to some serious stuff now. There's obviously two very important people here today without whom very little of this would be possible. And the great thing is, as the evening progresses tonight, most of us will get to spend more and more time talking to them. So you can please raise your glass and do a special toast, please, to the bar staff. On behalf of the Ryan Groom speaking for the night, I'm going to interview. I'd like to thank you all for being here. There are many people here who have travelled a great distance to be with us for this ceremony, and your presence is especially appreciated, so thank you very much for that. I'd like to thank Stu and Tony for asking me to be involved in the most important day of their lives. I know both have put a huge amount of effort into the planning of this wedding, especially Tony. And I can only hope that apart from this speech, everything else will exceed their expectations. So, it only leaves me now to close the toast to the immortal words of Shrek. Here's to love, laughter, and happy ever after, the new husband and wife, Stuart and Tony.
Cheers!
apologise to the fans because I don't have a lot to say. Basically, it's been covered up. Hi, Kat. We're good friends now. I want to thank Jason for taking the music on special notice. And he didn't really know what he was doing. And I want to thank you all for coming. I know it's been a lot of effort on your part, but all the people that mean something to us are here. And that's what we wanted. I want to say thank you to my mum and dad, because it wouldn't be here without us. For them. Stephen.
She's on toilet duty with your daughter.
You win, John. Because without them, Tony wouldn't be here. And just thank you for being here. And obviously to my amazing wife. You're right here.
Yeah, this is short notice, so I haven't actually prepared anything. First, I'd like to say that, Mum, you look absolutely stunning. Stuart, you haven't scrubbed up too bad either. Makes a change from the jeans and the Batman t-shirt. Obviously, Mum, I'll start off with you. Obviously, you've been there whole life, very, very important to me, and I'm so, so happy that you found happiness. please don't cry because you'll set me off. I'm trying hard here. I'm really, really glad you found happiness in Stuart. Stuart, although I may act like a knob at times. Most of the time, and I haven't made it easy on you. I would like to say that you have become a massive part of my life and a huge, huge inspiration to me. Wonderful, wonderful bloke, and I know you'll make my mum very, very happy. So, to my mum and Stuart, thank you.
Thanks, Beaver.
Spud!
Spud!
Spud! Adam. Adam.
Go sleep! He was asleep!
Has he gone to sleep after his dinner?
Yeah.
Hey. Where is he?
He's in the corner, come in! Sleepyhead.
Yes, I was asleep. Sorry.
Can't take the
Keith. Keith,
get it.
Move your butt.
Jason, stop selfieing.
I had a big job with it.
Whoa!
Because he's not done much to help us out at all, has he?
So we're getting a bit in it.
Thank you.
Pleasure. Thank
you. Runny. Carol. Take it there. That's not normal, Runny.
Jade!
Jade's not allowed this.
Is she not?
Look her eyes.
Can you use your classroom authority?
Thank you very much.
I was hoping that one had my name on it.
Jeez.
Oh, she's going to be happy with that. Oh,
thank you very much.
Abby?
Facey!
Where is she?
Better get your present.
Kimbo slice.
Thanks.
Whoa.
Thought I was
staying sober for the night.
You're not to have it now. Can't have it in here.
Never said that.
Take it to the bungalow.
I love your nickname.
Whoa, come on.
Karen.
Abby, you need to come back.
You got another present.
Don't blame me, it's as you gave him to me.
Thank you very much. Thank you so much.
Cheers.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank
you. Right, am I going to get through now?
What?
I'm still going.
No, we're still going. Right.
Still going.
One with mum? Two.
Which mum?
Thank you.
Just told him he's not getting
anything. No, you're not getting anything.
Thank you.
Bruh! Please open it.
Right.
What is it?
Okay.
Read it, it's really nice.
What is it?
Oh. Tommy Lee. Sammy Lee?
Fuck off.
Uh-huh.
Fuck off.
No.
Excuse my language.
That's genuine.
Do it. 110% genuine.
Joining us.
same difference. Here did I make more? All did I ruin all those tears, tears coming? What did you be all those nights? And I knew the first time I saw you with her, it was only a matter of
Stuart, many happy wedding days and best wishes for the future.
That's all? Is that all? Look after yourselves, guys. We really appreciate it.
Okay. Wedding,
well,
Tony, you looked absolutely gorgeous. And Stuart, you looked really handsome. They've got a really good time together.
And Dave Kent, although it's your wedding night, it's been a long day, so early to bed.
Congratulations, all of you. Well done for your marriage.
You looked absolutely beautiful in your dress. Good luck for the future.
Tony and Stuart, I've known you a few years, and I know you've had your ups and downs. But you've both been pretty good friends, and I wish you all the best. And I think you're going to be very happy together. And all the best luck. And I think you're both amazing.
Congratulations, all of you.
Yes, congratulations, Stuart and Tony. You're always supposed to be words of wisdom at this time, usually. So what can we say about marriage? Don't take each other for granted. Work hard every day at making sure that the most important person in your life is your partner, and everything else will be plain sailing. So all the best for the future. I would say cheers, but I don't have drinks. So cheers.